Nelson Mandela's widow Graca Machel today said she could feel the vibe after meeting the Duke and Duchess of Sussex in South Africa and insisted she was sure they would work together in the future. Prince Harry, who last met Mrs. Machel in London earlier this year, introduced the 73-year-old humanitarian to his wife Meghan in Johannesburg on the final day of the royal couple's 10-day tour to Southern Africa. Meghan spoke with her about staying in South Africa while her husband had been traveling, saying, "I've been holding things down on this side." Harry added, "I've done 5 or 6 countries in the past 9 days." As their visit nears its end, Meghan later told a business reception, "Whether for Harry, Archie and me in South Africa, or for my husband as he was traveling Botswana, Angola, and Malawi, please know that you have all given us so much inspiration, so much hope, and above all, you have given us joy." When they arrived to meet Mrs. Machel, Meghan said, "It's so good to see you." Mrs. Machel replied, "It's wonderful meeting you. I'm sure we're going to be working together in the future. I can feel the vibe." It comes as the couple mark the end of their 10-day tour of Southern Africa and hours after Prince Harry launched an extraordinary attack on the British media accusing the press of bullying and relentless propaganda. In a lengthy personal statement on his and Meghan's official website, Harry referenced Princess Diana and said his deepest fear was his wife falling victim to the same powerful forces that his mother faced. Today, Ms. Machel spoke to Harry, whom she met in London earlier this year and last in South Africa in 2015, saying, "Harry, welcome, it's so good to see you again." Harry then told Mrs. Machel, "You look amazing. How do you manage it?" Graca laughed, "No, no, no. There's nothing like that. Age doesn't." Speaking to Harry, she was heard saying, "It was so nice to see you in Angola," adding, "The Princess of Wales and all the steps she has taken. It was wonderful." Mozambique-born Mrs. Machel, an advocate for women's and children's rights who was made an honorary British dame in 1997, was married to anti-apartheid political leader Mr. Mandela from 1998 until his death in 2013. Harry has been visiting Southern Africa for 2 decades for holidays and conservation work, and has been to South Africa, Botswana, Angola and Malawi during this 10-day trip. Earlier, Harry and Meghan, who were on tour for the first time with their 4-month-old son Archie, met young people and entrepreneurs in a township in Johannesburg and visited initiatives tackling unemployment. Later, the Sussexes attended a creative industries and business reception at the residence of Britain's High Commissioner to South Africa Nigel Casey. More than 300 guests gathered for the event celebrating the UK and South Africa's business investment relationship and looking ahead to the Africa Investment Summit being hosted in the UK in 2020. In a speech at the event, Harry joked, "I think this is one of those garden parties that really kicks off once we have left." He added, "Although I have spent a great deal of time here over the years, this visit, in particular, has filled us with hope and optimism. This morning, we were among young social entrepreneurs in Tembisa, and it is testament to what investment, technology, and the right support can really do to transform lives and communities. These young people weren't in it just for themselves, each and every one of them was using the opportunity they had been given, and the skills they had learned, to give back and support more people within in their own community. It is also a perfect example of what we want the UK-Africa partnership to be about: youth, culture, innovation, high-tech business, investment, in fast-changing economies. All of you here today have a part in supporting a young and dynamic African economy, and I hope that you will use your links to the UK to help you do that." Speaking about the end of their visit, Meghan added, "Over the past 10 days our family has had emotional moments, we've poignant moments, we've had spiritual moments, we've met inspirational leaders in every walk of life, and we've been treated to incredible food, music, and dancing, but above all, we have been able to meet the people that are the rocks behind the sort of work that really means so much to us. It has been affirming to learn that we're not alone in the things that we believe in, and the principles we hold so dear." The tour later came to an end as the Duke and Duchess met South Africa's President Cyril Ramaphosa, and First Lady Dr. Tshepo Motsepe in Pretoria for a private audience. The Duke and Duchess were given his and hers watches made just for royalty as they met the leading creatives and business people from South Africa. Watch designer Lange & July presented the gifts to Meghan as she toured a reception with husband Harry at the High Commissioner's residence showcasing leading talent based in the Johannesburg area. The timepieces featured beaded straps in the colors purple, white, red, and blue for Nkosazana or Prince, and pink, green and yellow for Nkosazana, Princess. Mr. July said, "She said to me it's not just it's a watch that has meaning, a watch that has a story, that's so fulfilling. It has a little love note in it, which tells the story behind the colors which all have meaning." Meghan met a familiar face, Aidoka Gitlani, 26, a young woman she had a few years ago in Ireland. The 26-year-old said, "I told Meghan that in 2014 we bonded even before she was even a duchess. I had gone to the One Young World conference in Dublin and she remembered meeting me. I was in the audience and they asked for an opinion on social impact on the African continent and I stood up and gave an answer. Afterwards she said on the stage, 'I have to come and hug you.' She came down and hugged me and I took a selfie and she remembered today. And she gave me another hug." The businesswoman, who is a founder of the Wreath Aka Foundation, which makes solar-powered backpacks for kids, added, "It made me feel memorable and that the work I'm going is memorable and that she cares about people who do meaningful work." Nelly's Wafenti, 33, who co-founded the youth-led innovation firm Spring Age, said after meeting the royal, "My organization brings together young people to tackle our problems on this continent." Meghan loved it. She thinks the idea of the Millennial Board was great and important to go into corporates. Young people are our biggest commodity and sometimes they may not have stuff but they have their brains and we can bring them together.